Yes. So see now, first chapter in this business law is introduction to business law. So first thing I want to ask you all is what do you mean by law now? So in your opinion, what is law? So that I want to know now. In your opinion, what is law? What do you mean by law? Yes, unmute yourself and answer now. In your own words, what is law? What is law? Anyone can answer. Very simple, because in law we need to interact more, because all theory parts are there, and we need to write as it is. We cannot change and write it in our own word. We need to write as it is. So yes, so what is law? Ashish Bhandarkar is saying system of rule. So what about others? What do you mean by law? What do you mean by law? Yes, answer. System of rule. Yes, correct. System of rules, rules and regulation. Then others, what you can say about law in your own words, whether law is there everywhere, whether law is present everywhere, whether law is there in a college. Now can you answer me, whether law is there in a college, whether rules are there in a college? Yes, rules or set of rules. Disha is saying rules or set of rules. Yes, so everywhere you can see law. So if you are going on road, again you need to follow the rules, isn't it? If you are going on road, if you are driving, you need to follow the traffic rules. Suppose if you are going, or if you are coming to college, then you need to follow the rules of the college. So various things comes. So here law means set of rules and regulations. So that is very important. You need to understand this set of rules and regulation. But in a broader concept, in a broader concept, what you can say, who will decide or who will give the laws to us? Who will give the law to us? In India, who will give the law to us? Simple question. In India, who will give law to us? Means rules are given by whom? Rules are given by whom in India? Suppose India is a country, so everyone has to follow the certain rules and regulation, isn't it? So there is freedom of speech, freedom of expression, everything is mentioned. Yes, constitution. Isha is saying constitution. Yes, correct. Constitution. So whether our Indian constitution now, whether our Indian constitution is derived from other countries, whether our Indian constitution derived from other countries, yes. So it is derived from many countries, isn't it? So it is derived from Irish also. It is derived from America, USA also. So many things we have taken from some other countries. So and our constitution, you know, it is a written constitution. It is a written constitution and it is the longest constitution. You know, right? It is a written constitution and it is the longest constitution. So now we need to discuss about law. So we'll see this one. First thing we need to know, the meaning of law. So first you see, law is the system of rule which a particular country recognizes as regulating the action of its people and which it may enforce by imposition of penalties. So that means what? So you know the concept of court, right? So what is court now? Can you tell me court? Court means what? Court means what? Court. Yes, unmute yourself and answer. What is court now? Court. Yes, answer please. Legal institution. Yes, court is a legal institution where what they will do in court, what they will decide, right or wrong of some doing, right or wrong of some doing will be decided in court, isn't it? There are various court, you know, right? District court is there, then High Court is there, Supreme Court is there, isn't it? For all the matters which are not solved in the lower court will reach to the Supreme Court. In Supreme Court, what happens? They will decide whether the particular thing is right or whether the particular thing is wrong. So that is known as court now. So first thing we need to see here, meaning, see this, what they are saying, it is a particular country. So every country has its own rules. Suppose now we take example of Saudi Arabia. So suppose if we take example of Muslim countries and ours is Hindu country. So Muslim country and Hindu country rules and regulation, whether it is one and the same, can you tell me now? Whether it is one and the same rules and regulation in India and in Saudi, isn't it? It is no, it is different. So how different it is, can you tell me now? How different it is, can you tell me? Please answer, how different it is? How different it is? Suppose, now restriction for women. I am now on taking one example. Restriction for women are more in where? It is more in Saudi countries, not in India, isn't it? Restrictions are more on women there. So, and also, for certain crime, punishment is severe in Saudi Arabia. And here, punishment is very less impactful compared to Saudi country. So that is one more thing we need to know. So now each country recognizes regulating the action of its people and which it may enforce by imposition of penalty. Suppose if you are following the rules, whether there is any incentive is given to you? Whether if you are following the rules, whether any incentive is given to you? Can you answer me now? Whether you are following the law? If you are following the law, whether any incentive is given to you? No. No incentive is given, isn't it? But if you are breaking the rules and regulation, what happens? If you are breaking the rules and regulation, what they will do? There is imposition of penalty. So imposition of penalty, how they can impose the penalty? One, they can impose fine. Suppose if you are violating the traffic rule, suppose one example I am taking. So suppose if you are imposing traffic, violating the traffic rule, in that case what happens? In that case, fine will be imposed. Suppose if you are not wearing the helmet while riding the two-wheeler, fine will be imposed, isn't it? Suppose if you are wearing the helmet, whether 1000 is given to you? No, right? 1000 is not given to you. But if you are not wearing the helmet, 1000 is taken from your pocket, isn't it? So that is what we are talking about. Ignorance of law is no excuse. That means what? So now very important statement comes in law is ignorance of law is no excuse. What do you mean by that? Can you tell me now? Ignorance of law is no excuse means what? Ignorance of, what do you mean by ignorance? Ignorance, can you tell me the meaning of ignorance now? What do you mean by ignorance? What do you mean by ignorance? Can you tell me the meaning of ignorance? Anyone? Breaking the law. Ignorance means breaking the law. Is it correct? That answer, breaking the law. Ignorance means you don't know about the law. So ignorance means you don't know about certain things. So that is the actual meaning of ignorance. So here, ignorance of law is no excuse means negligence. Correct answer. Ankita is saying negligence. Ashish is saying lack of knowledge. That is correct answer. Lack of knowledge and negligence. So ignorance of law, no excuse means what? You cannot claim that you are not knowing the law. You are not knowing the law. You cannot claim. Means what? Suppose if you are, if you catch one bus, once you enter inside the bus, what is the duty? What is the duty of you? Suppose you want to go from one station to another station, one bus stop to another bus stop, and you catch the bus. So inside the bus, what is the duty of the customer? Can you tell me what is the duty of the customer? Can you tell me what is the duty of the customer once you catch the bus? What is the duty of the customer? Yes. Can you tell me? Very simple. Once you catch the bus, yes, to pay for bus fare. Yes, correct. Ticket. To pay for bus fare or ticket. So once you catch the bus, that is implied that you are going to somewhere. You are going to some destination. And for that destination, you are going to pay some amount, isn't it? You are going to pay some amount. So that amount is ticket fare. So if you are to take the ticket, yes. So if you are not taking the ticket, then you are not you are not deserved to go to that place because you are not paying something in order to receive something. You need to pay something in order to get something. That is also there in law. So that and all we need to see. So ignorance of law, no excuse means suppose you are hurting somebody. So now one more example I will take now. Now you are hurting somebody with knife. And after hurting or after injuring somebody with knife, what you will say? I don't know about the law. I don't know that physical threat or physical injury sustained to one person or physical injury is given to one person amounts to crime. That is there in law. Physical injury amounts to crime. And you have stabbed one person with a knife. After that, you are saying that I don't know about the law. Then whether punishment is given to you or not in that case, whether punishment is given to you or not in that case, whether punishment is given to you or not in that case, whether punishment, ಅದು ನಾನು ಹಾಕ್ತೇನೆ ಎಸ್ ವೆದರ್ ಪನಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ಎಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಪನಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಎಸ್ ಪನಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಸೊ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೈ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾ ಈಸ್ ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ನೌ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾ ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಅನ್ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ವಾಟ್ ಡು ಯು ಮೀನ್ ಬೈ ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾ ನೋ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಯೂಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ Ignorance of law, no excuse means what? I just want to know the meaning of ignorance of law, no excuse. Can you tell me now? Yes, Pramod, Pooja, Nishant, Amrita, Swati, Shifali, Disha, Rajat. Yes, Vivek. Anyone can answer. Anyone can answer. Yes, answer now. Yes, answer. Anyone can answer. So you cannot give excuse. That is it. You cannot give excuse. That means what? You should be knowing the rules and regulation of the country in which you are staying. So suppose now we all are staying in India, right? So we should know the rules and regulations of India. So that is very important. Suppose we are staying in some other country, then we should follow the rules or we should abide the rules of that particular country. So that is the meaning of this one. Ignorance of law is no excuse. So now you see, law is important because it acts as a guideline as what is accepted in the society. Each and every person should know the law to which he is a subject because ignorance of law is no excuse. So that is what we have discussed. So every person should know the law which is subject. Can you tell me the rules in college now? Can you tell me the rules in the college? What is a simple rule in the college? Can you tell me simple rule of one in the college? What is a simple rule? Yes. No ragging. No ragging, no using phone. Yes. Yes. Yes, correct. But more than that, there is one rule, right? Uniform, isn't it? Uniform. Everyone has to wear uniform. For day college, I am speaking. Uniform is necessary. So without uniform, if you are not wearing uniform, then no beard. No, yeah, Nishant is saying no beard. Then you need to wear ID card. Then tuck in the shirt. So various rules are there. And ragging also. Ragging is not allowed. So various things comes when you go to one place, compulsion is put. So what do you mean by compulsion? Compulsion means you need to follow the rules and regulation where you are in. So that is what. So now definition. Next is definition of law. What is definition of law? What you can say, what do you mean by law? Law is a rule of civil conduct prescribed by the supreme power of the state, commanding what is right and what is wrong. So here supreme power of the state means, can you tell me what is supreme power of the state? Yes, who is the supreme power of the state here? For India, who is the supreme power of the state? Can you tell me? Very simple. Who is the supreme power of the state? Yes, answer. Supreme power means here. In the question itself, answer is there. Can you tell me the answer? Supreme Court. सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया गिव्स यू सर्टेन रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन, दैट मीन्स अवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इज रिटन इन दैट वेरियस रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन आर मेंशन फॉर ईच इंडिविजुअल एंड एवरी सिटीजन, वॉट ई शुड डू, वॉट ई कैनॉट डू, दैट एंड ऑल मेंशन. इफ यू आर नॉट फॉलोइंग द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन देन यू आर पनिशेबल, यू आर पनिशेबल फॉर नॉट फॉलोइंग द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन. So your supreme power of the state means supreme court. So supreme court, what they will do, they will give you rules and regulation which states what is right and what is wrong. So what is right and what is wrong? So usually what is wrong is stated more, what is wrong is mentioned more in law, isn't it, instead of what is right. Are you agree with this statement? Are you agree with my statement? Wrong is stated more in terms of law instead of being right. If you do these things then you will be imposed with certain fine. So more information about not doing certain thing is mentioned in law. Doing certain thing is not mentioned, not doing certain thing is mentioned in the law. So that is one more thing. So now next thing you need to see, the objects of law. Why law is needed? Can you tell me why law is needed? So can you imagine this India without law? So there is no rules and regulation at all. Then what and all will happen? Can you tell me? In a country there is no rules and regulation at all, in that case what and all will happen? Can you tell me? No rules and regulation. In a place there is no rules and regulation, whether it will lead to more freedom or it will lead to more complication, whether it will lead to more freedom, robbery, murder, etc. Correct? Because there is no fear. Yeah, chaos. Because there is violence will occur. More crime. Yes. Because there is no freedom. There will be more freedom to do anything. There will be more freedom to do anything if there is no law. Isn't it? You can do anything. You can kill anyone. No one is asking. No one is putting you in jail. Because there is no law. So there will be more chaotic situation in that case. So to avoid all this, every country follows certain rules and regulations. So that is known as law. So now see this, two objects of law: to establish social economic justice and removing imbalance in socio economic structure. So imbalance, social imbalance means what? So what do you mean by social imbalance? So now there is a concept of rich and poor. Rich and poor, there is a concept comes. Whether law is equal to all? Whether law is equal to all? Can you answer now? Whether law is equal to all? Yes, isn't it? Law is equal to all, even if there is a rich, even if there is a poor. So what is the main statement in our law? In our court, there is one statement. You can leave hundreds of criminal, but one person who is not guilty should not be punished, isn't it? You can leave hundreds of criminal, doesn't matter, but person who is not guilty shouldn't be punished, isn't it? So that is the case here. So now social economic justice and to remove existence imbalance. So social economic justice, injustice, how it happens before, how it was for rich and poor, there is a differentiation among rich and poor, isn't it? In olden days, so rich will be treated with more respect and all, poor will not be given with any respect. So now in modern era also certain things are there, but in order to avoid these things, what they have done, they have given with certain rules and regulation. So that rules and regulation will help in removing social economic injustice or imbalance. So now we know the meaning of law. So basically, in short, what you can say, it is a rules and regulation stating what to do and what not to do. It is a rules and regulation stating what to do and what not to do. So that is known as law now. So now next thing is functions of law. So now you see functions of law. First function of law is establishing standards. So what do you mean by standards? Can you tell me what do you mean by standard? Establishing standards. What do you mean by standards now? Standard means what? Can you tell me? What is standard? Standard means what? What is another name for standard? Standard is set. So when we talk, we say, right, standard is set. So what do you mean by standard? What do you mean by standard? Yes. Yes. Answer. What do you mean by standard? A level of quality. Yes. Level of quality is set. Correct. Level of quality, we should reach that level. At least we should try to reach that level, or we can go beyond that level. That means we can go past that level, but we cannot be below par that level. So we cannot be below par that level. So level of quality, correct answer. So now standard means here rules. You can say rules also. Rules are also one kind of standard. If it is set, then you should follow that rules and regulation. So now first you see this example. Now causing physical injury to a person constitutes a crime of assault, isn't it? If you cause any physical injury to a person, in that case what happens? It amounts to crime. It is a crime. So giving threat to a person, defaming any person, so that and all amounts to a crime. So first is standard is set. So maintaining law and order. Second one is maintaining law and order. Law when enforced provides an order consistent with society's guideline. That means what? People are living in a society, isn't it? People are living in a society. So we should follow the rules and regulations of the society. Or else, in other words, what we can say, rules and regulations are framed by keeping in mind all the aspects of society. All the aspects of society, so rules and regulations are framed by seeing all the aspects. So that is what the meaning of maintaining the law and order. How to maintain the law and order? By following the rules and regulation given to you. If you follow that, automatically law and order is maintained. That is second thing. Now, resolving disputes. Resolving disputes. So now, what do you mean by dispute? Dispute means what now? Can you tell me? Dispute means what? What do you mean by dispute? Why dispute happens? Why dispute happens? Fight, quarrel, yes. Why dispute happens? What is the reason for dispute? If both the parties are not on the same page, isn't it? If both the parties are not on the same page, or meeting of mind is not there. Whenever there is two meeting of mind is not there, in that case what happens? There is a dispute or quarrel. Or dispute means, in short you can say, it is a disagreement. Disagreement of the one party. Suppose there is one common matter, one party will agree to that matter and another party will disagree to that matter. When there is a one agreement and one disagreement, of course that will lead to dispute, isn't it? So there is a favorable party. So one party is a favorable party and another party is an unfavorable party to the common topic, to the common topic. So that is known as dispute now. So resolving dispute, law helps in resolving or solving the problems. How it will solve the problem? Through a formal court system. See, we have already discussed the court system. Our country has court system. So for local matter, you can reach the district court. Then for if in district court is also matter is not solved, then you can reach high court. And final highest authority, you can reach the Supreme Court. And final decision on that matter will be given by Supreme Court. And once the decision is given by the Supreme Court, and that decision cannot be changed. And it is binding on all the people. That is binding on all the people. So that is third point. Then fourth one, protecting liberties and right. How protecting the liberties and right? So see, these restrictions are imposed when person is going to unlawful act, going to do unlawful act, or after unlawful act, punishment is provided. So can you give the example now? Restriction is imposed when person is going to do unlawful act. Any example can you give me now? Before doing the crime, restrictions are imposed. How? How? Can you tell me, anyone? Before committing any mistake, restrictions are imposed. How? Anyone? Anyone can tell me how restrictions are imposed before doing the mistake or crime? How restrictions are imposed? Can you answer in the chat box? Can you answer in the chat box? How restrictions are imposed before doing the crime? See, very simple. Restriction means here rules are given. So rules itself, I have already told. So not doing certain things are more in law. So rules are given before itself. So if you are not following the rules, means you are not you are doing certain mistake or crime. You are doing certain mistake or crime. So what happens here? What happens? You see this. Restrictions are imposed when person is going to do unlawful act. Or after unlawful act, see this. Death penalty may be there. After unlawful act, there are various things. Death penalty may be given. Or lifetime imprisonment is given. So various things. So recently what they have done is, see this rape case and all. So now there are more rape cases in India. So because of that, now recently one new act is passed. New act is passed. Can you tell me the name of that act? Can you tell me the name of that act? Anyone? See, this is general now. This is not related to the this one. So generally I am asking you, can you tell me the name of that act? Because of excess amount of rape in India, one recently new amendment came and one new act is passed. Yes, what is the name of that act? Can you tell me? Can you tell me the name of the act? Yes, anyone try to give an answer? Anyone try to give an answer? What is the name of that act? Anyone can tell me? Yes. So I hope I am not wrong. The name of that act is Disha Act. Disha Act, isn't it? Disha Act is the name of that act, the criminal law. Yes. But recently, according to that act, within 21 days, what happens? Yeah, punishment is given for the person who is doing unlawful things. That is, in this matter, rape. The person who is doing the rape, for them, punishment will be given within 21 days as per that act. But whether that is implemented, that I don't. But act is done. But whether actually it will take 21 days or more than that, that you know, right? Our court system, how it is? Can you mention the court system of India? How it is, court system? Suppose if you file a case in a court, how long it will take to give one conclusion? How long it will take? Anyone answer? How long it will take? Suppose, yes, 7 to 8 years. Pramod is saying 7 to 8 years. Yes. See, suppose now I have one property, but I am the rightful owner of the property. But property is not divided because it land sector this property at 10 to 15 years. Yes. So sometimes now recently Ayodhya case, it was from last one century. Many court proceedings were done. Now recently, finally, the place belonged to Ram Lalla. Now they have declared. So that is about the Ayodhya case. So our judiciary is very slow. Our judiciary is very slow. I don't know why our judiciary is very slow. What may be the reason? Can you tell me what may be the reason for slowness in our judiciary? Whether our system is corrupt, whether our system is corrupt, or whether the people who are handling the system, or whether people who are handling the systems are not doing the things what they wanted to do? Yes, Akamsha is saying yes. See, so there are many things comes. Yes. So corrupt system may be there. I think both. Yes. Both. Yes. Rules are framed when in 1950 the rules are framed. And Indian Contract Act 1872. That is again. See now. What is the year we are in? 2020. So some of the rules may be outdated. So again there are certain amendments are added to the rules and regulations. So now Article 370, so you know right now Article 370, that thing happened. So various new things are adding to the law. But main concept of the law is same. Main concept, what are the basic concept of the law, that is same. So that won't change, but new and new things will come into place as and when time is going to pass. So that is fourth one. Now, so these are the things. See, functions of law, four points are given. First is establishing the standard. That is nothing but setting the rules and regulation. Maintaining the law and order. How to maintain the law and order? By following the rules and regulation. Resolving the dispute. If there is any dispute, then we can go for court. So that is how we can resolve the dispute. Protecting the liberties and rights. That means what? Suppose there is any unlawful act, then punishment is given. So these are the functions of law. These four things are the functions of law. So next we need to see about branches of law. Next thing we need to see about branches of law. So what do you mean by civil law? First thing is civil law. Now what do you mean by civil law? What do you mean by civil law? Can you tell me whether civil law and criminal law is one and the same? Whether civil law and criminal law is one and the same? Or how you can distinguish between civil and this one criminal law? No, Pramod, Rajat, Anusha, everyone is saying no. It is not one and the same. Common law. See, civil law is common law? No, that is wrong. Common law is different. Common law is different. Now, civil law means all the law which requires contractual agreement. All the law which requires contractual agreement. And if you commit any mistake or any unlawful act under civil law, in that case, what happens? In that case, imprisonment is not given. Imprisonment is not given in the case of civil law. Instead of that, wrongdoer will have to compensate, the other party. Yes, penalty. Penalty will be imposed. Penalty will be imposed by the to the wrongdoer's party, and that person or the wrongdoer have to pay the penalty to another party. So that is what the meaning of civil law. See, this, any dispute that doesn't involve criminal charges falls under this category. Means now suppose this one property case and all, yeah, civil law. It is civil law. So, unless it is a physical injury to the person, it all the things comes under civil law. And here, party in default pays the damage or compensation. Yes. Now, party in default means the person who is committing the crime. The person who is committing the mistake or committing the unlawful thing will pay the compensation to the suffered party. So, suffered party. Other party means here, suffered party. So, that is now clear. Civil law. Now, criminal law means, criminal law, you know. What and all crime? Killing, kidnapping, everything comes, right? So that and all amounts to crime. So if you are doing such things, then you are punishable as per the Indian Penal Code. IPC, Indian Penal Code is there, right? As per that, you are punishable. So that is known as criminal law. Physical injury is involved in criminal law. Now third one, industrial law. So what is industrial law? Can you tell me industrial law? What do you mean by industrial law now? Why it is needed? Industrial law. Industrial law governs business enterprises or large scale industry. So industry means what happens here? There are two party comes. So here in industry or in any business or enterprises, there are two parties. Who and all? Very basic. Two parties. Who and all? Can you tell me? Two parties. Labor. Yes, correct. Shifali is saying labor. So labor means employee. Labor means here one employee. So one more party. One is employee. So one more party. What is one more party? Can you tell me? Employee and, yes, answer. Employee and employer, isn't it? Employee and employer relationship is discussed under this law. So if there is any disagreement between employer and employee due to any event, due to anything, so that is solved in industrial law. And any matter relating to the industry or any matter relating to the business is discussed in industrial law. So that is the third one. See this, it is related to business and industrial enterprises. It governs the relationship between employer and employee. Very clear, third one. Fourth one is constitutional law. So constitutional law means rules and regulation given by our constitution, Indian constitution. So Indian Constitution, there are, so Indian Constitution is useful for parliamentary procedure also. So everything is mentioned. See this, to become a prime minister. So you all have studied this one, Constitution, Indian Constitution. Whether there is one subject, right? Indian Constitution. In that there is various rules for becoming a president. Isn't it? Various rules for becoming prime minister, then who is a speaker, then what is the rules governing speaker, who is a judge, who is a judge of the high court, then what are the rules and regulation for supreme court judges. So everything is discussed in this law. Then what do you mean by emergency, what type of emergencies you are having. So everything comes under constitution. So this fourth one, see this, constitutional law means deals with a study of practice and principles set forth by constitution. In short, you can say it is a study of our Indian constitution, that is constitutional law. Fifth one, environmental law. Environmental law means what and all environmental law is there? Environmental law, can you tell me? Environmental law, it protects from various type of hazards. So hazards means what now? Various type of hazard means, can you tell me? Various type of hazard means what here? Hazard, what is the meaning of hazard now? Yes, what is the meaning of hazard? Yes, regarding pollution, correct. Regarding pollution, then regarding to climate, yes, pollution means that itself. So now climate change, regarding water pollution, then regarding our this one, animals. So there are various laws are there. So for animal also there is certain laws. And for, see now, the Save Tiger mission is there. Save Tiger, yes, natural calamities, correct. Which I saying natural calamity, Save Tiger mission is there. So various things comes. So in order to protect the environment from various external disaster created by the man. So man itself will create the various things, right? Man will do the harmful act to the environment. So in order to protect the man from doing the unlawful or harmful act to the environment consists of all the things. So this type of law is created, that is known as environmental law. So sixth one is international law. So why international law is needed? Why international law is needed? So to build healthy relationship between two countries. So whether international law, see now, how is our relationship, India-Pakistan relationship, whether law is proper, law is there, but whether relationship between India and Pakistan, whether it is proper, can you answer now? Everyone knows whether it is proper relationship between India and Pakistan. It is not proper. Why? Because of terrorist activities committed by that particular country, isn't it? Pakistan is doing terrorist activity. That is why India is very, very careful whenever they are dealing with Pakistan. So that is why rules and regulations are there, but there are some loopholes in rules and regulation. So that and all we need to see. So international law helps in building healthy relationship between two countries. Can you give me the example of healthy relationship? India and which country has healthy relationship? Can you tell me example? Fastly you tell. India and which country has a healthy relationship? Yes. Yes, USA, correct. USA, Russia, correct. Russia, see, from Russia we have imported various, flights and all, we have imported from Russia. And from USA also, USA, see, now Donald Trump and all came to India and Modi also went to USA. So various things happened. So there is, they are trying to create one bonding between two countries. And in USA also Indians are more. So, and Russia, I don't know. And Israel, yes. Israel also, correct answer. So, why healthy relationship is needed? Suppose any enemy country is planning to do attack. In that case, you want support from your neighboring country, isn't it? You want support from your neighboring country. So suppose whether there is a good relationship between India and China now, can you tell me whether there is a good relationship between India and China? No, there is no good relationship. That is why we are now started banning various things now. Apps and all we have started to ban. Then I don't know about PUBG and all. PUBG banned, but it is not from China, I feel, because I have not played PUBG, so I don't know. about the origin of PUBG. Whether it is from China, I don't know. Please answer whether it is from China. It is from South Korea. Okay. It is from South Korea. But still they have banned because of Atmanirbhar thing. Atmanirbhar thing. China had a share in PUBG. Okay. Yes. I don't know. So yeah, correct. Maybe that is the reason. Now Atmanirbhar Bharat, because of that thing, we are banning other countries' inventions. So, and we are creating our own. So instead of PUBG, now 4G game is now they are saying that similar to the PUBG, 4G game is coming. So that we need to see how it goes, whether how it will earn profit to Indian economy, how it will help in raising the GDP and all. We need to see. See, last one of this class, business law. Lastly, business law. What do you mean by business law? Business law means law relating to trade and commerce. Business law means what? Law relating to trade and commerce is known as business law. See this, the person who enters the business transaction, and he may be individual, he may be any person. So here, a person who enters the transaction may be a sole trader. Sole trader means what? Who is a sole trader? Can you tell me fastly? Sole trader means who? Only one person doing the business is known as sole trader, or else association of person. Association of person means it may be a cooperative society, it may be a partnership firm. So there are many things comes in business law. So business law is related to trade and commerce. So business law is also known as mercantile law or commercial law. So what are the other name for business law? Mercantile law or commercial law. Yes. So this is about today's class. So see this, branches of law: civil law, criminal law, industrial law, constitutional law, environmental law, international law, and business law. So total 7 branches of law is there. Next class we are going to discuss sources, and about contract and all we are going to discuss in the next class.